What's up, everybody? This is Jack from Crypto49er, bringing you on my journey into cryptocurrency. Before I start each video, I give away a 0.1 Litecoin to a random commenter of yesterday's video. The only request is the comment has to be about something you learn about cryptocurrency. All right, let's get started. And the winner is Crypto Dude. Okay, liked. Yeah, that's not something you learn, Crypto Dude. So let me reload this again. As I mentioned, guys, if you can't, if you don't find anything to learn, just go and watch some other YouTube video and come back and let me know what you have learned from them, perhaps. Pretty Williams. Hey, Litecoin is mooning at 68 LTC. Alright, Pretty Williams. Yeah, it's going up. I mean, I'll take this as at least something that you learned. I think yesterday's winner also talked about Litecoin. So let's get a live Litecoin update here just to take a peek. I haven't really checked today. Hey, go up another 5% today. So from your comment to now, it actually went up to $72. This is awesome, actually, in my opinion. So you see Ethereum's going up. Some stuff here going up, some stuff going down, but mostly it's going up. That's great. So yeah, now looking forward to Litecoin going to 100. So let's keep it up. All right, let's give you your 0.1 Litecoin. All right, congratulations, Pretty Williams. You got your 0.1 Litecoin. On to today's video. Today's video is what I want to call Lisk Nano Wallet Fail. I didn't create this thread. Apparently someone else have already back in September 27 this year. This is what I see when I try to log in to Lisk Nano. Every time I try to log in, it says passphrase is not valid. So yesterday I was heaping praise on how Lisk was so easy to set up compared to IOTA, and I didn't need any guide and stuff. But when I try to log in this morning, and I have been trying to log in since, I'm not able to, because the one thing that I didn't mention yesterday was that yes, Lisk is kind of like Exodus with the setup process, but it's not anywhere close. Exodus has the backup pphrase, but they don't ask you to use that as a login. Lisk, on the other hand, asks you to use that passphrase to log in. At least that's my understanding. If I'm wrong, well, that's probably the reason why I can't log in. This is, it's just incredibly stupid in my mind, because if you can ask someone to use the passphrase to log in with that whole entire 12 keywords, fine. I mean, I made sure I copied it down, wrote it correctly. But the thing is, and you guys tested it, the Lisk wallet actually asks you to type in like keyword number 5, and I typed it in and it was correct. It was like, okay, you go on to the next step and you completed your setup. But it's incredibly dumb, I would think, that, you know, if you're gonna make people use the passphrase all the time, why don't you make sure that the passphrase is valid before letting people put funds into this wallet? Because I put funds in the wallet, and then the next thing you know, I can't access it because my passphrase, for some odd reason, does not match what was created. I double checked it, and I make sure the order was correct, because order matters, but right now, it's not working. So, a little pissed about it, but at the same time, it's a learning lesson. It's one of those things where I'm glad I didn't invest much into Lisk, and things like this can happen, I know from the beginning, so, but it's something that I learned personally that I'll never, ever put in any funds into a wallet before I double check to make sure that the passphrase or any sort of lock that they put in is working properly before I actually put any funds in. Because in this case, yeah, the passphrase, I thought, because this is in my mind, that's the reason why I didn't think to double check the passphrase, because I thought it's going to be like Exodus where, okay, you get the 12-word passphrase, now you never need to use it unless you need to recover your wallet, which I'm like, unless I delete the app or unless my computer crashes, then I'm like, okay, I will be in trouble. So I didn't think to really test the passphrase. I didn't know that Lisk was going to make me use this passphrase as a password. And that's why I'm now stuck. So according to this guy's thread, he's like, this guy was stoned, he was baked. I'm sure he was on weed or something when he was making his wallet. And he was still able to recover it because it's a list of words that BIP039 uses, and it's just the list of all the words they use, 2048 words. From that 2048 words, 12 were picked, and from those 12, they have to be in a certain order, and that 12 will generate that mnemonic. So he was able to find that he wrote down upload was actually uphold. So for his case, that one word was screwed up, but at least he was able to find it and able to log in. For me, I confirmed every one of my words are on this list. I didn't make a typo or anything. I didn't write the wrong word down. So my guess right now is the order screwed up somehow. So just letting you guys know right now, if you invested into Lisk like I have and thinking of using the wallet as I suggested, which I still believe in using wallets compared to just leaving it on exchange, you definitely need to test that passphrase before you actually use it. And I'll be doing that for with every single wallet I'll be using from now on. So that's pretty much a lesson learned for me. So this other stuff, like I've found a few other threads about, you know, what to do. There's actually a Lisk passphrase recovery tool. It's pretty interesting. So someone built this recovery tool where if you remember, if you have 11 of the words, 11 of the 12 words, so you know one of your words probably is incorrect, you'll have this tool that actually will go through and try all 24,000 combinations to find that missing word for you. So that sounds pretty cool. Actually, I have it running right now, but I don't think it's gonna work. But man, it might, I don't know. I really doubt it, but you know, I'm just running it. This is just to see. So, but right now, this is a pain in the butt. So, but that's how, you know, that's crypto life sometimes. You have to be extremely cautious with Lisk passphrase. And I would think now from my lesson learned here, any passphrase that gets set up following the BIP 0D9 protocol. So let me know if you guys have any ideas, suggestions on how I could recover my passphrase. If you know any, definitely leave a comment down below. But that's all I have for today, guys. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon for post notifications. If it isn't crypto, it isn't worth mining, it isn't worth speculating. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.